Wet and windy, the two best words to describe our August tight lines experience. Unfortunately, things just didn't set up for us this time around. We were booked right up until Thursday, so our pre-fishing was pretty weak. Nevertheless, we moved a few kings on Friday during our pre-fish to lock in our options for tournament day. We even snuck in a quick rescue mission for longtime fisherman Gary.
Like, seriously, you have a rain jacket. Why would you put it on?
Because real men don't wear rain jackets.
You get some good footage?
I think so.
Fortunately for most, the call to shift the tournament day to Sunday happened Friday evening, so it was a day off for us. We started off with hot fish off the bat. It was a mixed bag of rainbows, kings, and cohos, but that was to be expected considering our confidence was out deep in the zone. By 8 o'clock, we were working with a 3-fish box averaging around 10 pounds. Not much, but it was a start. We just had to continue weeding through small fish in hopes to find more rogue kings.
Here we go.
We managed to find one more solid coho and dropped a couple other solids through the day, but unfortunately we ended off with a less than placeable box of 4 fish. Back to the weigh scales, and after 3 boxes, we knew it wasn't worth waiting. Plus, we had 2 trips the following day, so we needed to get back at a reasonable time. Anyways, a big congrats to Team Diabolical on their first place finish. It's been another wild tournament experience here on Lake Ontario. Mm.
Hope you guys enjoyed that video. Been a pretty busy season for us, so it's been tough to crank out videos. I've overheard some guys saying they're a little disappointed in my performance on YouTube this year, so I'm working on it. Just bear with me, but just wanted to say a big thanks to all you guys that are constantly supporting and sending positive feedback on my videos. It means a lot. It definitely boosts the morale and keeps me motivated to do more of these video clips. So, yeah, big thanks for that. Big thanks to you guys. You know who you are. Right on. Okay, moving right along. I do have some things that I want to say. I know it's kind of boring listening to someone talk for 3 or 4 minutes, but I think these are pretty important and have come up in topics of conversation with people that watch my videos. I've had quite a few guys ask me, you know, how did you manage to become a deckhand and what kind of qualifications did you need? And to be honest with you, I had no clue how to fish for salmon. I'd never done the trolling thing before. I was just starting to get a little bit excited about it. And I graduated from high school, didn't really know what I wanted to do. So the following summer after graduating, I was working at Sail Outdoors and I just didn't like the work that I was doing. So I decided, hey, why don't I call a boatload of charter boats? And I had no clue that deckhanding was even a thing. But I figured I would give it a whirl because why not, right? I was super excited about just fishing on Lake Ontario and, you know, it caught my eye. So I figured there's got to be work opportunities there. So I called probably 25, 30 charter boats, big and small. I had no clue how to tell the difference, really. I just saw websites and I called. And honestly, it was the last person I called was Moby Nick. And he didn't need work at the time. He had had a full-time deckhand, which is Keelan, the guy that you always see in my videos from tournaments and stuff like that. And he actually had another boat down the dock that needed some help. And it was the foot in the doorway kind of thing. You know, it was good experience, great practice. Basically, from there on, I took the following year, I did some part-time work on Nick's boat, and that allowed me to get some experience on the Rod Wrestler, which is Nick's rig. And the year following that was my first full-time year. Keelan moved on, found a full-time job, and did the whole growing up thing. So, yeah, kind of filled in his place and followed in his footsteps. So that was how I got the gig. You know, it wasn't terribly hard. It was just, you know, it worked out. You know, I connected and I got the opportunity. But I had to continuously call. It wasn't just like, oh, call up a boat and boom, there's the gig. It was to the point where I was like, I'm going to call this Moby Nick guy and I'm probably going to get rejected and I'm probably going to be really mad. But turns out that last call was the one that got me connected and to where I am today as a deckhand on Nick's boat. So that's how I got it. And honestly, it's I think a lot of people don't realize that there's a lot of really good opportunities like that. And just in general, you know, just calling, asking, talking to people, networking. I think that's something that a lot of people disregard. And those are usually where the best opportunities come from. So getting all motivational on you guys, sorry. But that's how I got the gig on Moby Nick's boat. That leads me to my next topic, actually. As most of you probably know, I am a student still at Niagara College. I'm studying TV, film, and broadcasting. Going into my third and final year, I graduate next April. And I've got placement lined up, which will hopefully lead to a full-time job and a career, some sort of career anyways, in the real working world. And I have to take that. That's a part of growing up, and as much as it's tough, I have to do it, just like Keelan had to do it when he moved on. So with that being said, I think that you all should call Nick if you are young and ambitious and you're willing to learn. The most important thing Nick always told me when I was learning the ways of the deckhand, whatever you want to call it, was be a fresh slate. You know, be open to learn. Don't come on the boat trying to teach someone that's already got the system down packed. Learn and take away from it. So yeah, it's all you really need. Just be young and ambitious and you know, willing to learn. Anyways, guys, that is everything I have to say in today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed that sweet little snippet of our tournament experience in August, and we'll see you guys in the next clip. Peace.